Hi, today I'm gonna show you how to etch PCBs at home the more conservative way. So first you need an exposure box that usually looks like this or smaller, and you have to have either LEDs or fluorescent light. Turn it all like this. Come on. And so the first step is to design and print your design onto a transparent thing and place it there. And then what you need to do is get, let's say, a PCB photoresistive piece, peel it off. So you can see. So make sure that you have a limited lighting in this room, and then place it on top of the PCBs you want to make, and then place this baby here, close it and turn it on. Now it usually takes about 4 or 5 minutes. Other people use it up to 8 minutes. It depends really. You have to run through some tests to see how long and what are the optimum results, and it usually depends on if you have LEDs or what type of fluorescent you're using. This is done, so let's see what happened. And quickly throw it into this tank. I don't recommend putting your hands in there, so what do we do now? We shake it. And as you can see, we have our board there. If you can't see everything, then it means it's ready. Usually you need a couple of seconds, but you have to make sure you can see everything before you put it into the ferric chloride. Okay, that seems about right. Now this is done. We need to throw it in here. So we open it. And throw it in. And we wait. It usually takes like 5-10 minutes, and considering that the liquid in there is quite old, so it is not as powerful as when it was new. So this tank is full of this, which is natrium hydroxide. Here's the label, and it comes on, let's take a peek inside, those granulated pieces in there. For etching, I use this baby here, which is, if we can shine some light on it, it's a mega bubble etch tank PA104 that is heated and also creates bubbles as well. And this is my second machine, but if you don't want to buy your own, you can easily make one like this. So if I show you what the contents are, let's see. So we place our ferric chloride in there, and then we use these nets to hold the PCB. And then I used PVC piping to send air in it and create bubbles. I didn't have a heater though, because making one yourself is kind of hard and dangerous sometimes. And if we take a peek in this right here, you can see the PCBs that I believe they're already etched. So let's take them out and see what happened. see what we have here. This is just water, although it seems like it has more shit in it. Okay.
Yeah, that's better. So, as you can see, these babies are quite done. So the next step is to take them over to this cutter here and cut them into pieces like this. And that's it.